Good late Wednesday evening. I am certified meteorologist Nick Kelly checking in on this May 8th of 2019. We had yet another start to the day with kind of a loud night with the morning batch of rain and thunderstorms working through. They were strong to severe, but thankfully they were weakening as they pushed on through. And it played to our favor today since we didn't have to deal with an afternoon batch of severe thunderstorms and certainly going into this evening. And thankfully more dry time is on the way. We definitely need it. Before we get to where we're going, let's start with the time-lapse from Indigo Sky out of Seneca, Missouri, or just outside of Seneca. Definitely shells the morning batch of rain and thunderstorms. Nothing severe over Seneca or over the casino grounds there, but definitely quite a bit of rain to start things out. And it wasn't just areas in and around Seneca. It was everybody dealing with that morning batch of rain and strong to severe thunderstorms as that rotated on through. And notice behind that, when we got the bulk of the rain out of here close to lunchtime, we held on to the clouds overall. That really kept the atmosphere fairly worked over. We were quite stable throughout the course of the day. The atmosphere didn't really get a chance to destabilize again before any thunderstorms out of central Kansas tried to work in. And again, we are thankful that dry time is on the way because we need a dry out, not just from this morning's rain, which averaged about almost an inch across the area, heavier amounts west of Chanute and Parsons, but especially since Sunday, since this multiple rounds of rain and thunderstorms began. Area-wide, we've seen the rain average amounts, according to radar estimates, at 2.6 inches. But look at this. Isolated spots, especially around Yates Center and going back over to Wichita, isolated spots pushing 5, 6, 7, 8 inches. Some spots seeing possibly over a foot as you work closer to the turnpike and to the southeastern sides of the Wichita area. So we all need a good chance to dry out. And thankfully, we had a good chance to do that throughout most of the evening. We just stuck with mostly cloudy skies. We've been keeping an eye on thunderstorms that have tried to work in from the west and working to the east. Two things have happened, though. One, most of the thunderstorms have taken the more northeast track to continue toward Topeka, Lawrence, and Kansas City up to the north. And along the southern edge here, we are trying to see if we can get at least a few more scattered showers, maybe a random thunderstorm to get going. But it's having a tough time to do so, which is, again, all the more helpful for us just to accumulate as much dry time as possible. So we'll have at least a chance for at least a few scattered showers and thunderstorms tonight and maybe another quick batch going into Thursday afternoon late. Thankfully, though, the weekend we will have more in the way of dry time, not to mention temperatures turning mild again after we have quite a bit of a chilly day tomorrow. We are watching a stronger storm system that will want to sneak back into the picture by the middle of next week. That could give us a better shot of rain and thunderstorms. In the short term, at 10:50 from 7th and Rangeline, sky staying quiet but socked in with the clouds. 64 degrees with the south wind at 7 with the humidity kind of high at 90%. Temperatures across the rest of the area just before the 11 o'clock hour chimes in had most of us mainly in the lower to middle 60s, but you notice that northwest wind working into our far western counties, especially around Iola, Chanute, Fredonia, Sedan points north and west. That is the cold front working through. Once that northwest wind kicks in, you'll definitely notice a chillier air that will work in, especially as we work into Thursday. For many of you, we'll have midnight highs around 63. Then we'll stay in the 50s, not just through Thursday morning as we get at least a little bit of a break from tonight's scattered rain chances, but we stay chilly all day long with hot temperatures, rather, staying in the 50s all day. So we'll continue to keep an eye on these scattered rain and thunderstorm chances on the Skywatch Storm Tracker. In general, we're not worried about this being a loud night like it has been the past few nights around here. Also helps that we're getting the bulk of the rain chances out of here, finally, with this passing cold front as it continues to push to the east. Also, we look to the upper levels to see, not only are we seeing this upper low finally move on out, that's also going to take away much of the rain chances once we get into tomorrow morning. I will say, though, there is another weak little disturbance trying to get going around parts of Utah and Colorado. That could graze us as we head into Thursday, and that's what could lead to at least a few widely scattered showers, maybe a random thunderstorm or two, going into Thursday afternoon. So for tonight, safe bet that everybody stays socked in with the clouds. We have midnight highs in the lower to middle 60s. So wherever you are at midnight going into Thursday, that is the warmest that will be for your day tomorrow. Because as that cold front works in, we'll have that northwest wind kick in going into the morning drive. And I think by the morning drive, most of you should be starting out on a dry note, but definitely you'll need the jacket. We'll be starting out, some of you on the Kansas side in the upper 40s, everybody else will be in the lower 50s to start, and we just stayed chilly all day, even with the quiet starts of the afternoon, and potentially that quick wave coming out of Colorado could try to trigger a few scattered showers, maybe a random thunderstorm. Regardless, it's going to be a chilly day with temperatures near 53, not only to start the morning out, but also by lunchtime. Maybe a quick jump to 56, but it's going to be a struggle to warm up as this cooler air mass works in behind the cold front. Quick look at Friday. Has us at least partly cloudy and dry going into Friday morning. Cool, though, with lows starting out in the mid-40s. And then we look pretty okay going into Friday. Any rain chances stay west and south of the area. We'll go partly sunny for your Friday with afternoon highs back at least into the lower 60s. You can see for the next few days, it'll be kind of chilly, definitely with some cool mornings across the area. Another quick wave wants to work in on Saturday that could bring in some scattered showers, otherwise mostly cloudy with highs near 62. Mother's Day, we're keeping it dry and quiet for now with highs near 71. 74 Monday, then we warm back up into the upper 70s, middle of upper 70s by the middle of next week, and that is when we'll have to watch for potentially a stronger storm system to work on in. Have a good night. Have a great Thursday.